Hey guys, HD, Home Depot, just a few moments ago came out with news that there has been a security breach. This is just a prime example of what can happen, in the intraday, intra-minute, if you don't have a game plan, if you're not paying attention, if you get into a trade and you walk away from your desk. Those are all big no-nos because of events like this that come out of nowhere and have a, pretty intense reaction to, news like this, that there has been a security breach. So we had a nice pull from 92.75 right down to 90 bucks, which is, almost $3 in about 10 minutes here. So you can see what has happened to the daily chart. We were in a nice uptrend, breaking to 52s, 52 week highs, and then this big snap happens in a matter of minutes because of the news that came out midday here. So interesting stuff that happens in the stock market, and it happens all over the place. So you've definitely got to be on your toes when you're getting into trades and managing trades. And, one of the things that I always consider is, why am I taking this trade? And are there going to be any catalysts, positive or negative, that will affect the outcome of my expectations? And if at any point, after I get into a trade, after I buy or I short, if I start to rationalize in my head for any reason, I already know that I'm most likely going to lose money in that trade. And that's because, when you're rationalizing to yourself, you're most definitely breaking your rules. And, the market is a very humbling place. If you think you know it all, the next trade, you're probably going to get slapped in the face pretty good. So it's a good thing. I think it's a good thing that the market, will humble you from time to time. But if you've got an effective, trading plan and you manage your risk effectively and you choose trades that are going to offer you a solid risk reward where you're, risking 10 cents to make 30 or 40 cents, those are the types of trades that I look for. Trades that are 2-to-1 or 3-to-1 or 4-to-1 in terms of the reward to risk ratio. But designating your risk is one of the most important things as a trader that you'll learn through time. You have to understand how much you're willing to lose before you can get into a trade. Because if you don't know what your risk is, you're pretty much flying blind. It's like trading without level 2. And prints, time and sales. It's just something that you develop, through time. It's not something anyone can teach you per se. It's more of a self-experiencing type of learning, which is good for me because that's how I like to learn. But so Home Depot here taking a little nosedive intraday. You can see just a nice refresh bounce here on low volume. So these are just shorts covering their positions here. And now we should have the next leg down. So if we break down this $90 level, this thing could definitely flush a few more bucks. So be careful out there. Let's check in on our ISNS really quickly. Still in the grind. ACHN. Still in the grind. CSIQ making moves today. Nice chart breakout on the daily. So very, very nice move here. We broke through this 36, 70 to 80 cent resistance range. but this chart's been trending very nicely after its earnings came out a week and a half ago or so. But for now, it looks like we've got this double top in. Might fade back, but all these dips have been getting bought up all day. Dip spot, dip spot, dip spot, dip spot, dip spot. So definitely a good trader, a thick trader. So it's very liquid. You can get in and out with pretty much whatever size you're rolling with. So, good deal. All right, take care. We'll make another video soon here. Peace.